civilmedia.mk. Slobodno, nezavisno, otvoreno.
The majority of the population is actually not part of this process of fake news and hate speech, although those who are doing that are very loud and going at the first place because they are doing really bad job, and we see the consequences in the previous decades of that. Especially we see the consequences now when we live in a digitalized era, when we live in a society which is based on internet technology, spreading the information not just from a village to village or city to city, but around the globe, around the world. But also we have to mention, this is the second thing, that the social media actually are tools, just tubes. They are not life, they are not media, such as the traditional media, which are led by the journalists, editors, camera persons, etc., etc. These are just tubes. And actually behind each fake news or each hate speech lies or stands a real person with a name and surname. So it's not the social media as itself spreading the fake news or the hate speech, but person, personality. That's very important as a start of the discussion. I will say that there are two main questions when discussing these very, very important topics. First is how to encourage debate, real debate, without hate speech and without discrimination. That's what we have to answer and try to answer. And the second is how to make the real news, or one of the participants previously said, just news. How to make news and information more worthy or more clickable than the fake news. These are the $1 million questions that we should work on, not just debate, and find the answers, because if we find this answer, we can focus on battling and winning this battle. So I will give one of the answers again with a question. How many of the institutions that you know, all of you here and virtually, actually, or public authorities, have moderation policies on their social media accounts? How many of them? Moderation policies that encourage debate, which means they discourage hate speech, discourage fake news, and most important, take concrete measures against this. I'm not talking about negative comments, which means I disagree with your policy, which is fine, which is democracy. But I'm talking about comments with a hate speech, with discrimination, with a lot of fake news. I will say my answer will be almost none. What's yours? You can name it, maybe demand me, or maybe just confirm that that's true. So I don't think there is a need, especially for us here and on the other side of the auditorium virtually, to remind that the hate speech may lead and actually leads towards concrete criminal acts. That's true, because it's most probably that a lot of the people that use hate speech may do something which is really criminal and problematic at that moment, or maybe later. But my main topic, and I will give a conclusion with this for today, will be what's the focus, or what public institutions can do in this important fight. Because these two processes, as you have put in this agenda, the hate speech and the disinformation, are really problematic, and we should tackle as one. So what actually the public institution can do? First is act. They should start acting, not just talking. Acting most in prevention, but also to be more effective in sanctioning all the criminal things that are happening in these two topics. Second, creating atmosphere for debate through inclusiveness, and which will include, that means different opinion, especially different opinion that are different from the actual government parties in power. This is not just for now, it's for the past. It must refer also to the future, because we have to actually agree that democracy means different opinions, but it doesn't mean opinions with a hate speech, a discrimination and fake news, but means different opinions, because debate is crucial for the democracy and for fighting these negative topics we are discussing. Third thing, creating moderation policies that we spoke about. Because as in the regular criminal law, when we talk about predictability of what you should do or should not do and have a sanction, the same thing should be applied here, which means moderation policies have to clearly state what's not acceptable on the social media of the institutions, of the public authorities, clearly state what's not acceptable because it's going against the law and it's problematic. So which means moderation policies, which will encourage debate on arguments, encourage debate on facts and not on hate speech. The fourth thing, I think also the professor before me mentioned the education process, which is really, really important. And I won't take a lot of time to say this because it was mentioned before, but also institutions should be an example in creating inclusive communication and educate how to do it. Because we need more personal, more institutional examples than a debate. And the fifth and the final advice, which will help us fight and battle this two negative phenomena, is giving professional, timely public services. So each public institution must give professional services because that will lead towards satisfactions to all citizens, which will make fake news, but also hate speech, really, really decreasing. Because giving equal access to everyone, which is really important, taking steps, concrete steps against discrimination, which leads through the example that public institutions should do, can make the change. Actually, I strongly believe that this is just one part, but as a start of discussion, this will be the main start for our journey, and it will help us to win these two battles. One against the fake news, and the second against hate speech and discrimination, which are really problematic, and which combined together makes the society looks like it looks now. And if we do not take concrete measures now, that means that maybe later will be too late.
Civilmedia.mk. Свободно, независно, отворено.